Hi everyone, this is Brendan here and we are on to our next episode, episode 7 of our Sherbet challenge. So for this episode, I only have 190 housing spaces available to work with. So the first one was given by Ben. He asked me to use 1 minion, 3 valkyries, 23 goblins, 15 wall breakers, 30 archers, 30 barbarians, 1 dragon, 1 lava hound, clan castle to be 7 wizards, 7 goblins and to use 3 jump spells. However, I counted it up and it totaled up to 189, so I decided to add 1 more goblin, so it totaled up to 24 goblins. And also, I don't think it's fair for me to use 3 jump spells because I've already been handicapped to not use any heroes for this particular army combo. So I'll be tweaking my spells a bit, so you guys will actually see what kind of spells I've been using. So for this particular attack itself, I decided to do a little bit of a differentiation. I decided to attack from the bottom left and then the top right using some barbarians and archers to try to take out the wizard tower first, which actually did happen, eventually dropping some more wall breakers to try to break through the walls on the top left. So going by the same entry point and dropping my troops in the same particular order. However, there's no golems or giants to actually tank for the damage, so I decided to substitute them with some valkyries first, and in fact my clan castle containing the wizards came out and then they did a lot of damage. After that, it followed by the lava hound and the dragon. The lava hound will be able to tank the damage off the air defenses so that the dragon will be able to survive the whole entire battle. And then eventually dropping the rest of my troops, dropping the small little barbarians, archers and also the goblins that I was given. And then eventually just saving up one more minion just in case I need to try to snipe or maybe take out one more of the other building that would be able to do some more damage to my other troops. However, won't be able to do any damage to any air troops such as the cannons, the mortar and maybe the wizard tower that would be actually doing more damage to the dragon than actually to the minion. So now just cleaning up the whole entire base with the minion that I'm left with. And then eventually the pups, they just take out the remaining structures. So none of the defenses, they could attack the air. So just taking out the rest of the other remaining structures. Defenses have already gone down. And eventually getting us the 3 stars. And now going ahead with the next one that was given by Ramos. He asked me to use 30 archers, 30 barbarians, 25 goblins, 2 witches, 15 minions, 1 dragon, 8 warbreakers, and 1 P.E.K.K.A. So I felt that his way of presenting the whole entire army combo was really awesome. In fact, even stating to minus 1 spell, minus 1 hero at those specific troops that I mentioned. However, the calculation was slightly wrong, Ramos. You actually calculate out to a total of 200 housing spaces. So I stated that I will minus 10 goblins. So in the end, I brought 15 goblins with me, total up to 190 housing spaces. So just going ahead with the raid, attacking from the top left again, the same usual spot. Goblins are not too much help this time because there wasn't enough goblin. Usually the goblins will be able to take out the elixir storages on the left and the right much quicker. And then now following up with the dragon preparing to drop on the bottom left. Bottom left will be able to take out the wizard tower itself. Wizard tower will be able to go down really quickly. And then eventually once the air defenses they have gone down, it's safe for the air troops to go in such as the dragon. That's why I only deploy it at that particular time. I didn't want to deploy it too early because I didn't have any lava hounds to tank for the dragon. So I didn't want my dragon to go down pretty fast. So just deploying the rest of the minions that I was given, the 15 minions, just slowly deploying them to just clear out the remaining structures. And then eventually just waiting for them to just clear out the whole entire base because there's only the 2 wizard towers on the top that could actually take out the remaining troops. So just continuing the raid, some of the minions have just got taken out by the wizard tower, but not to worry, there's still the dragon that's still alive, hoping that the health is more than enough to tank the damage and then eventually end the raid for us. So just continuing letting the dragon just soak up the damage for the minions. Minions, some of them has gone down also. But not to worry, I deployed some more minions on the top right to take out that wizard tower. And then eventually the dragon just continue with just like maybe 90% of the HP left. So yeah, 3 stars again. So let us proceed on into the next one that was given by Matt FIFA. He asked me to use 20 barbarians, 20 archers, 10 wall breakers, 10 minions, 6 giants, 6 hawks, 3 valkyries, and 26 goblins. So with this army combo, there ain't any troop that's more than 12 housing spaces. So I'm able to use all my spells and also able to use both of my heroes. So technically speaking, it's not a very difficult army combo to use given the fact that I'm able to use my spells and also my heroes. But I decided not to use all the spells definitely because just using the heroes alone, they are already very strong. So just going ahead with the raid, and then just letting my heroes just rampage through the whole base, and then my clan castle, I've already gotten a golem just for the fun of it. And then eventually my heroes, they just continue rampaging through the whole base, dropping a rage spell over there so that they just rage up and also they walk faster, eventually just taking out all the defenses really quickly. So yeah, if you guys want me to have a more difficult time to actually do this challenge, it'll be better to give me all those troops that has more than 20 housing spaces or more, and then so that I won't be able to use my heroes. Otherwise, using one hero is like as if using two or three P.E.K.K.as. Like the Archer Queen, she's pretty strong, not pretty but very strong. So just having her on the battlefield is really just going to get a 3 star. So the second last one was submitted by Ivan the Lunas. He asked me to use one Golem, one P.E.K.K.A, one Dragon, one Lava Hound, two Warbreakers, one Archer, six Giants, six Balloons, one Wish and one Valkyrie, and to use clan castle troops and also any spells. So I'm able to use only one spell given that amount of troops that I'm being given. So I decided to use one rage spell. After that, you guys will see it. And I did mention that I won't be able to use any heroes given the fact that I'm able to use one golem, one P.E.K.K.A and one dragon. Also one lava hound, which actually technically minuses four heroes. So able to use no heroes, but using a rage spell, one rage spell is relatively good enough. So the balloons I decided to conserve to the end of the battle to use them on the wizard towers as usual. So just going ahead with the raid, and then the dragons is already taking out the elixir storage on the top. I didn't exactly want it to go there, I wanted it to go into the center so that it could help out the lava hound tanking the damage over there. So it was a good thing. So just give you guys some heads up about the next few episodes. I'll be doing more episodes on this kind of raiding, especially when the housing space reached to like 120 or whatever. I'm pretty sure I might fail a lot. Fail to the extent whereby I might even give up this whole entire series. But who knows, I might continue maybe doing all the way to 80 housing spaces. I've never really go ahead and try it out to do like 80 housing spaces or less. But we will see as how it go. So yeah, the next one was given by Westin. Westin asked me to use one Lava Hound, two Witches, one Healer, five Wizards, 15 Minions, 15 Archers, 15 Barbarians, 11 Warbreakers, and one Dragon. So he said he did the math equals to 19 spaces, and you are right, Westin. So yeah, good job. So going ahead with the raid, they're just continuing to attack. So other than that, I wanted to update you guys also, saying that the next episodes, I also might be tweaking it up a little bit. Probably might not be able to use certain stuff. Maybe I might tell myself I won't use heroes even though I've been given the chance to use. But we will see if the troops combination is really too difficult, then I might still have to use my heroes. But I know a lot of you guys have been asking me to use healers, all healers and heroes, this and that. But I already know the result, which is it's definitely going to be a 3 stars. Because even just using all healers and then dropping my Archer Queen, the Archer Queen will just take out the air defense, and the air defense, once it goes down, the healers won't get damaged, and then after that they just heal the Archer Queen to full blood. I've even seen people using a level 1 healers with like a level 13 or 15 Archer Queen and just 3 starring the whole entire Sherbet Towers because of the range of the Archer Queen. The Archer Queen's range is so far to the extent whereby she can actually take out the air defense without the air defense even doing any damage to the healers. That's depending on how the AI of both of the troops actually work. So yeah, it really doesn't work out that well for me to go ahead to use a Archer Queen with mass healers to actually attack Sherbet Towers. But I might do a video with a mass healers together with a Archer Queen, doing on a normal raid, maybe doing it at Champions League at 4,000 over trophies. So we will see how. Maybe after this whole entire series, I might do it. So stay tuned for that, which actually gave me the idea of maybe doing like a mass single troop at 4,000 over trophies in Champions League. That might be really awesome. Maybe those people being attacked by me might be a little confused, maybe looking at someone using like all barbarians or all archers or in fact all goblins to attack their base at such a high trophy level. It might not make sense to them, but then yeah, it's just for the fun of it. So we will see, maybe I'll create another new series, a single troop series or whatsoever. So do stay in the comments what you guys think about it. Maybe you guys can give me some heads up whether I should do that kind of series or whatsoever, if you guys are interested to watch those kind of stuff. So proceeding on to the next series, I would like you guys to choose the army combo for me again, having 180 spaces available to choose take note, 180 spaces. Please do the math before you guys submit it. So hopefully you guys will get it correct again. A lot of you guys have been submitting wrong values, such as like 200 or even like 130 housing spaces, which we have not reached to that episode yet. So with that said, I'd like to thank you guys for watching my video, and clash on.